Today's news. If the sex is bad, leave. South Korea wakes up to its sexual revolution.
To begin today, the article we are covering is from TheGuardian.com and it is linked down below along with Steph's paintings if you want to click and check it out. And it generally talks about this specific woman who owns a shop called PleasureLab.net in Seoul in the neighborhood of Dosan. It's an adult shop.
Well, and it talks about another woman who is an author as well, who writes a blog on embracing your sexuality.
As well as tweets every time she goes out with the man because she's single and she dates a lot and she tweets whether or not the sex was good. It's interesting because as a whole, South Korea is still extremely conservative with all this stuff, sex we're talking about here. So I want to start with a statement from the article. It's difficult for women to take a leading role in South Korean society when it comes to sex, Kwok said. Men always took the lead in sex, which meant, for a long time, sexuality for women did not exist. Giving pleasure isn't shameful, but in Korean culture, when women talk about pleasure, people will call her a whore. I could not agree with this more. There were certain topics you were not allowed to talk about there if you were hanging out with a group of Koreans. I totally remember this.
And I think to a certain extent that not only is Korean culture, but is culture in many parts of the world.
There were certain times when you and I would be sitting with one Korean friend and we could talk about anything. There were other times when you and I would be sitting with a group of people and certain subjects just could not be broached. So yes, they are open-minded when they are sitting by themselves, but if they're sitting within a group of their own peers, all of a sudden the amount of things that you're allowed to talk about goes way down, it becomes more narrow.
And I think there's a certain amount of, if you're talking to somebody who's outside of your country and outside of your cultural context, maybe things are a little bit more open to talk about because they're not necessarily going to ever go back and talk to your parents or your other close friends and family members that you grew up around, so it'll never get back to you.
I remember this one time when you and I were first dating and we had gone out with some other friends to a nightclub or some kind of like bar slash club atmosphere where we met this gentleman who was about our age, a Korean guy. He was sitting by himself and he and I got on to the topic of female underwear. We were talking about thongs and they didn't really exist in 2009 or 2010 in Korea, or you really couldn't find them that much.
You could find them, but you found them in underwear stores. I can think of one particularly, and they would call them teabags and not thongs.
But anyways, this guy was just so happy to chat about it with me, and I think it would not have been a conversation we would have had if two or three of his friends had been sitting around, especially if one of them was female, because she probably would have just felt embarrassed. The thing is, it is changing over there. The article also refers to the Korea Queer Culture Festival. The article got the information wrong. It said that it started in 2015, but I actually covered it in a video in 2013. I was there. I mean, you've been there too. I remember you came later, but it's been going on for a while. It's just every year it seems like it's actually more of an uphill battle. Like the government got blocked by the Christian right over in Korea last year and they couldn't even get their permit to hold the Korea Queer Culture Festival in the city hall spot where they normally do it because they had done it a couple years in the past, and then this year the church or whatever got in there and filled out all the applications for the slots that were available, and then there were no more slots available and they couldn't hold their festival because you have to get permission to hold the festival. I'm just saying how difficult it is for certain things to be broken the mold that's already sort of institutionalized there.
Well, Korea has been a very conservative culture for a very long time, and it also, I feel, to a certain extent got even more conservative because of certain aspects, like, for example, American cultural influences in the 1950s. I think there were a lot of things that actually made Korea a little bit more of a conservative culture than it may have been a long time ago. However, Korea is undergoing a revolution. A lot of young people have different ideas, different mindsets. I know that we're seeing it a lot in Korean dramas, this change of mindset of, in order to live together, we have to be married versus people who are just living together. This juxtaposition we are seeing a lot in dramas, and we're actually also seeing it with some of our friends that we've talked to in Korea.
Yeah, two groups of friends that we have recently were not forced to get married, but were strongly encouraged by their folks to get married because it was time for them to move in together. That was the next logical step, but the parents were like, no, you can't live together unless you're married. it must be this way. And so they both went and got married first. And so now they're married and now they're gonna live together and find out what that's like. Mm. Which is fine because that's their culture, but it takes freedom away from an individual and puts it on the older person. And that's really not our experience. We can disregard what our parents did because that's not what we want necessarily.
I don't necessarily agree with you in that statement. And I think that it depends upon your family. It depends upon what your upbringing was. It also, Korea has been undergoing this revolution that we kind of as American culture underwent in like the 1990s, I feel, but it's happening much faster for them, and there is so much changing in Korea since the 1980s. They're still adjusting, and while they've adjusted in some ways and shapes, like technology being so advanced, they're also struggling to try to advance in other ways, which is more being open-minded, talking about things. And I think that it's important to have discussion about sexuality and sex, because if you don't have sex education, that's when you start having the problems. You know, if people are more aware of things, that you're much less likely to have things like unwanted, unintended pregnancies, sexually transmitted diseases. All of these things are a lot less likely if you have sexual education.
And the reason why we're covering this is because I feel like a whole entire gender has been left out to the side because they don't have a say in their own sexuality, their own sexual choices, because it's so male dominated over there. It takes women like this to come forward and be strong about it and actually do things that no one's expecting, like talk about what happened on the date and how good the sex was on Twitter.
Well, and this is part of going back traditionally, even when we were living there, we would have discussions. Men were expected to take care of all of the contraception. You know, and I mean, mind you could go and get birth control at the pharmacy as a woman, but it was expected that the guys would do it. If you're going to have a baby in Korea, you needed to have the guy to sign off on the paperwork and say that he was the dad in order to take the baby home. It was a very, and still is, a very male-centric culture, but women are starting to say, hey, we're living in a new society now. We need to take care of ourselves because who else is going to?
An interesting conversation and subject matter indeed. Comments down below your reaction to what we said, or if you read the article, or just your perception or experience with sexuality related to Korean culture.
This does not mean that it is not controversial or what we are talking about is not controversial, because we know that it is, and your opinions may disagree and differ from ours, and that's okay. The important thing is to have the conversation.
That's right. It can happen down below. Comments, you guys, click the like button while you're down there. Thank you so much for supporting us here at Hollywood Back and the artist staff. Click the bell for notifications. Check out the link to KGAL. And don't forget to subscribe for more Hollywood Back news. That's it. We're out of here. Hasta luego.
Bye. Because this is my first life, it really showcases this whole concept. Because they have one couple who they're living together, but they're not actually married, and discussing that. There's another couple that they move in together, their parents are upset, so they do end up getting married because of that. And then you have another girl who is like, she's trying to embrace her own, like, I'm woman, hear me roar. She has like condoms in her purse and she walks around without a bra sometimes. And that's like, oh my gosh, so scandalous.
This is my first life as a Korean drama.
Because this is my first life. Stars Lee Min Ki and Jung So Min. And it just finished airing.
I'm just happy to hear that dramas seem to still be trying to take the lead in what's right on the peripheral of Korean society. So good on them.